getting set to, just about set to start the second half of play here. A 10-point lead for the home team, the Contra Costa Comets, as they lead the Mendocino Eagles in this Bay Valley Conference matchup. And it's a game that Contra Costa needs to keep ahead of the Marin Mariners, who are 5-2. And for Mendocino, they came in tonight at 3-4 in conference. So they need this one really to stay in this Bay Valley Conference race. And the scoring leaders in that first half, Larry Wicked with 8, Alston with 7. On the other side, Blachnik with 7, and Jamar King with 7. Now, Jamar went down with that injury, went out shortly thereafter, has not returned. He's not on the floor here to start the half, and of course, he didn't start the game either for the reasons that we told you earlier, because he's been on some recruiting tours for football, and maybe next season we'll see him in an Alabama uniform or possibly Ohio State. Very exciting. All right, second half underway. A 10-point lead for the Comets. Shannon defense already coming out. Here's Blachnik. Gets it to the outside for Avia. Dribble drive, double team comes. That chases Stiliga out of there. Crabtree puts it up and knocks it down. Noel Crabtree. Born on Christmas, that's why his name is Noel. And he knocks down his first basket of the game. And it's 37-30 after he knocks down the three. There's Stephen Thong getting it back. Comets looking for their first basket of the half. Stephen Thong, the long three, and he knocks it down. Bobby from downtown. And that allows the Comets to reclaim a 10-point lead, 40-30. Stiliga driving, puts it up. Can't get the shot to go, but he does draw the foul. And it looks like the culprit is going to be Jeremiah Alston, number 25. So Stiliga going to get a chance to shoot a couple of foul shots here. First one, and that one rattles home, 40-31. And remember, the ladies get underway immediately. I don't want to say immediately, but following here, this first one, that will be our nightcap game. The next one is good from Stiliga, so he gets them both. It'll be Contra Costa against Laney. Comets and the Eagles again, but the Eagles of Laney, as the women will have the nightcap of our doubleheader. Inside, Deontay Smith. They haven't gone in there very much tonight. And Bobby leaves that one up, doesn't get it. The shot put up and home. And a good looking play that time by Jeremiah Alston, who's now got 9. Offensive rebound and a putback for Alston. 6'5 out of San Lorenzo High, fourth leading scorer on the team. And right now he is the leading scorer. He leads everybody in scoring here tonight. And that's going to be a foul call. I believe, was that going to be a non-shooting? I think it is. It didn't look like they were attempting a shot that time. So the Eagles will inbound from the baseline, trailing it by 10. 19:02 to go here in the second half. Avia gives it to Tyrell Jones. Jones looking for some room. Thought about going baseline, now playing back to the basket. Stiliga, the long three off the iron, no good. Blachnik chases down the rebound, back out to Stiliga. Stiliga with the spin, pretty finish! Underhand off the glass and home with the spin. Oh, that was a beautiful play. 42-34 now. Well, Paul Stiliga has made some beautiful shots here tonight. Back to that zone. Here's Bobby Siebenthal. That shot won't go. Ball tipped around. Looks like Jones has got it. Transition, kind of bumping into one another. So the transition defense is there. Oh, boy. Look at that move right there. DeLiga doesn't get it, but Jones gets the putback. Tyrell Jones slashes first, shoots second, plays above the rim. 20 points, 20 plus points per game in conference play. And Tyrell, 35 against Los Medanos with five dunks the other night. Here's one knocked away and stolen. That's Noel Crabtree. A long three-point shot off the rim. That's Lachnick again. Offensive rebound here for Mendocino. This one has to be saved, but right to the Comets as the Eagles turn it over. Steven Thong. Lachnick out there to cover him. There's Lachnick out at least make sure the Comets don't shoot those open three-point shots. Good job by Mlachnick to get out there on two different shooters who are open momentarily beyond the arc. Here's a three-pointer into that won't go. Tyrell Jones had it, tipped around, finally saved from the baseline by Jones, fighting with it, fighting over it with Larry Wickett. DeLiga defended well by Deontay Smith, who made his change and shot. Smith made his defense felt right there. Here's a shot that's taken. Tips the back part of the iron. Way too far that time. Tyrell into the paint. Upton puts the shot up. Doesn't get it to go, but he does draw the foul. And it looks like they're going to get number 23, Jalen Dominique, with the foul. Second team foul on the evening, in the second half, rather, for the Comets. And Tyrell Jones will go to the foul line. 42-36 in favor of the Comets. Jones first shot and he rattles it home. And here comes Jamar King back into the ball game for the first time since that spill he took in that first half. So Jamar back into the ball game for the Eagles. And Coach Billy Ofel. Second shot, and he knocks it down. So Jones gets them both, and it's 42-38. And you look up at the scoreboard, and you see just a six-point lead for the Comets. And through most of this game, it seems to me that the Comets have really outplayed the Eagles, but they can't quite shake Mendocino. Left-handed shot put up, and that is good. Good-looking runner pulling up there is Jeremiah Alston, and now Jeremiah's got 11 points to lead all scorers. 44-38, Jamar King on the inside, and he stuffs it home. Big wide body, Jamar King, but he's also got a lot of skills, too. Here's Jones ahead of the pack, off the glass, that won't go. And the rebound by Alston, keeping it away from Jamar King, nicely done by Alston, sullen to the rack. Body's knocking around, and the ball's going to be out of bounds as he left that dunk a little bit short. So Sullen not able to finish the dunk, and right in his way that time was Paul Stoliga. And it looked like Stoliga was inside the restricted area, but no call there. Of course, I don't have the angle that the officials do, but apparently Paul was just outside of that restricted area, so that was not the call. But in any event, timeout on the floor, and the Eagles have trimmed the lead down from 10. It was 37-27 at the half. It stands now at 44-40. So the Eagles have stormed out of the gate here in the second half. They are up 6 here in the second half as they have cut the lead down from 10-4. Jeremiah Alston leading all scorers. He's got 11. And it's a 4-point lead for the Comets. They've led through most of the ball game, but early on in that second half, we were kind of seesawing back and forth after the Comets had led early, but they have led primarily in this ball game, but the Eagles have been down by as many as 10, cut it back to 1, And on another occasion, they had cut it to two. This one tipped away. That'll be out of bounds. Sullen knocking it away from Tyrell Jones. All right, here's Stoliga. Watched by Dwight Wilson. Stoliga, right wing. Tried to get it into King, but it's knocked away by Wickett. Two on one, racing the other way. Here's Wilson, leaves it way short. Nice defense that time by Stoliga to deny the basket. Stoliga, right wing three, off the rim, no good. Jamar King, the rebound, has it blocked away. Jamar King one more time, and he puts it home. Bobby Siebenthal came up with the block initially, but Jamar King did not quit on the play, able to get the block shot and put it back. So Jamar King having himself a nice night. He's got nine. This one knocked away. Now the officials get between Anthony Sullen and Tyrell Jones to try to prevent any type of a fracas from breaking out here. I credit the officials for that. Sometimes these things start out kind of slowly and then build into a melee. And the officials, now one of the officials coming over, and that is Ray Mike, talking to Anthony Sullen a little bit. As Sullen goes to the free throw line to try to add to a two-point lead, off the back iron, no good on the first. So Tyrell Jones coming out of the ball game now, and off the bench comes like number 32, DeAndre Russell. Now, pardon me, it's number 22, Herman Brown of the Eagles, and now a misplay in the backcourt, almost a basket. Sullen has another chance. He can't put it home. They battle for it, taken away by Mlachnik. Left wing three, and that won't go, and that missed by Crabtree. Putback won't go. They tap it around as they volleyball it around here a little bit. Out of the pack comes the Comets with the ball. Here's Sullen with the basket and the foul from behind. Jamar King got him, trying to prevent the basket, and now a chance for a Comets three-point play. So Anthony Sullen breaking out of the pack there with the basketball. Jamar King picking up the foul. And Jamar going to come out of the ball game now as Tyrell Jones quickly back in. 47-42. Sullen trying to complete the three-point play and does. So it's a Comets three-point play and they lead it by six, 48-42. Mlachnik can't get it to go, but there is number 22 with the putback, Herman Brown, and another basket here for the Eagles. They pulled it within 48-44, and Miguel Johnson has seen enough. He calls timeout as the Comets want to talk this over. The Eagles making a run at Contra Costa College, and we'll run right back here to Bay Area Sports TV, and we'll be back in just a moment. Traffic. Here's Larry Wickett going baseline. And the shot won't go. Another chance. And that one is good. It's like Anthony Sullen got that one. I was blocked off by the official there momentarily. But in any event, it's a Comets basketball, and they lead it by six. And now, good defensive harassment that time provided by Bobby Siebenthal. And that helps create the turnover as Herman Brown called for traveling. So some nice defense that time by Bobby, and it creates the turnover, and the Comets get the ball right back. Go for Mendocino. Good years in 2011 and 2012. They made the playoffs. And they won the Bay Division of the Bay Valley League. A shot is put down. And that was Jeremiah Alston. He's got 13 now. Here's some double team defense in the backcourt. Comets steal it. Dwight Wilson, he is fouled going to the rack. So some more good defense by the Comets. And Wilson will get a couple of foul shots. So they won the Bay Division, did the Eagles. 2011-2012, they made the playoffs. Four winning seasons in Billy Ofel's first 6 years at the helm. And we told you, Mendocino, more of a shooting team, but they haven't been able to get the ball inside here a little bit tonight as Wilson hits the first. But they are not a tall team. Jamar King, really the only guy with a whole lot of size on this ball club, so it really behooves them to shoot well from the outside. But they have been able to do that pretty well. They've been able to move the ball up and down the floor well tonight. Here's more of that full court pressure. Really harassing defense right now. Double team here creates a never turnover. We're going to have a block shot and another foul. And Dwight Wilson back to the free throw line. So full court pressure that time. Good on ball defense as the Comets able to cover up the inbound passer to help create that turnover. And now I think we're going to have a technical foul call, and I think they're going to get the Comets. And now a warning to Juwan Harvey, number zero, who's checked into the ball game. So I believe it looked to me like Matt Amaral, one of our officials, called a technical foul. So Dwight Wilson going to shoot his two foul shots. He makes this one. And I think they got Dwight Wilson with that technical. So I think after Dwight shoots his next free throw, I think they might be walking down the other way to shoot a technical foul, but we'll see. Amaral had his back to me as he was looking toward the scorer's table. Well, apparently no technical foul call. I'm pretty sure he teed him up, but he had his back to me when he made that call over to the scorer's table. And this one coming right to us. And boy, that almost got him a piece of the equipment. I was talking to Tim Banks earlier about that. He says, well, sometimes it happens. It almost happened right there. Courtside right here, opposite side of the scorer's table is where we are. You see it on your screen there, the scorer's table sort of in the background. And now we're going to have a foul call away from the basket this time. And they are going to call Ray Jackson, number 11, with the foul. And the Eagles will inbound here with 12:10 to go, trailing 56-44. So the Eagles were able to get close, but some good defense has propelled the Comets back to a big lead here. They lead it by 12. Lachnick, the drive, pulls up and passes instead. Tyrell Jones, here's Noel Crabtree with a floating jumper, that won't go. A little bit of a running jumper that time as he was drifting to his right, couldn't get it to go. Here's Wickett, almost skipped and traveled, no call there, the three is missed, ball comes loose. Eagles have it. Here's Noel Crabtree, he wants a three and he knocks it down. Good work by Mendocino as they get the three-pointer from Noel Crabtree. 56-47, 9-point lead here for the Comets. Comets into that half-court set. Wilson dribbles to the inside, kicks it to the outside, shot, and that is no good, but we are going to have a foul call, and that will be three foul shots for the Comets. So that cardinal rule is broken here. Do not foul a jump shooter. The Eagles do, and number 11, Ray Jackson, will go to the line for not one, not two, but three free throws. So Coach Miguel Johnson certainly has got this team going in the right direction, playing excellent basketball right now. And when he first took over the first two seasons, the first shot is knocked down. He kind of struggled a little bit. Coach Watson had the team before that when they had an excellent season. They won the conference and then graduated all their sophomores. The next shot, that won't go. And those players were recruited by Miguel Johnson. So it took him a couple of years to sort of get this thing turned back around after he took over. A foul is called here, and the Eagles will inbound from the side. But to turn it around, he has done just that. And they are leading the Bay Valley Conference with an overall record of 17-6. All right, here's Latrell Upshaw running the point right now for the Eagles. Gets the ball to the inside. Jones has it in a crowd, puts it up at home. Terrell Jones, man in his face, able to throw up that little righty hook and get it to fall. 57-49 in favor of the Comets. Long three-point shot, that won't go. Blachnik the rebound. Comes into the front court. Double teamed on the sideline. The ball is gonna be out of bounds, and let's see who's gonna get it. The Comets are gonna get it. So one thing the Comets have been able to do is provide some double team pressure no matter where it is on the floor, and it's been very effective several times. They've not only slowed the ball down, but they've actually created turnovers with that tonight. Showed a little of that full court pressure. That also created a couple of turnovers as well. Inside, back outside, Anthony Sullen. Gets the lane, off the glass, can't get the shot to go. Jones the rebound. Baseball pass into the front court, it's gonna be intercepted. Jeremiah Alston with the good hands, that time to take it away. Alston, lefty three-pointer off the rim and no good. And now a bumping foul. As the Eagles were coming in to the front court, coming across the timeline. And that is gonna result in foul shots. And it looks like it's gonna be foul shots for Terrell Jones. So a couple of different occasions tonight, it looked like the Comets were gonna pull away, but the Eagles have been able to battle back each time. Lead at half was 10. The Comets got it back to within 4. Then the lead ballooned back to 12 after some splendid defense by Contra Costa College, but the Eagles have come back yet again here. Trail it by 8 and trying to make it 7. They won't do it here. The ball knocked out of bounds by number 23, Muhammad Holloway. But the Rock remains with the Comets. 9:40 to go here in the second half. Here's some full court pressure provided by the Eagles. Here's Stephen Thong with a good ball handling. They get the ball across the timeline easily. Wicket outside. No jump shot that time. Stephen Thong down into the corner. Thought about it, now takes the baseline, puts up the fall-away shot and knocks it home. Oh, Ray Jackson had an open three-pointer, decided against it, took a much tougher, albeit shorter shot, but it was a fall-away and he got it to go. Jones spinning off the glass at home. What a finish by Tyrell Jones. Pretty play from the Eagles as they come right back. The lead again is 8. Oh, and the alley-oop slam, Stephen Thong to Wicket, and now a steal here in the backcourt. More good defense, shot put up, and that is good. Ray Jackson with the defense and the bucket. And the lead is 63-51. Nearly taken away. And now bodies fly. Blatchnick and Larry Wickett. They get together, both men hit the floor, and the officials right on top of this one to make sure that this one does not elevate into something ugly. Larry Wickett was very upset after that last play when he hit the floor, but oh, what a sequence there. You had Stephen Thong feeding Larry Wickett for the alley-oop slam, second alley-oop slam of the evening for the Comets. And then you had the steal and the basket by Ray Jackson. And then more defense nearly produced another turnover, but it ends up being a foul, and Blatchnick will go to the line. And right now, the Comets look like they're pulling away again. This is a one-and-one situation. Blatchnick misses the free throw, but Jones gets the rebound. Jones in trouble, double team, gets it to number 14, Paul Stoliga, but Stoliga can't hit. Wickett tries to get it over to a teammate, Jeremiah Alston, and that one gets loose and it's out of bounds. Tyrell Jones. Eagles trail it by 12. Tyrell to Stoliga. Stoliga outside, three-point shot. That rattles out. And the defensive rebound not collected, not held. And the shot put up and missed badly that time. But Blatchnick gets in there with the offensive rebound and the putback. Good work by David Blatchnick. Able to stay with that one, and the lead back down to 10, folks, and that's where we were at the half. So right now, things all even here in this second half. Comets by 10, there's an air ball. This one's gonna be out of bounds, but last touch by Latrell Upshaw of the Eagles, and the ball stays with the Comets. 7:37 to go here in the second half, and the ladies will get it going following this game. Ladies, the nightcap tonight. And now the official, Rayshawn Fulcher, talking to some of the players. Inbound to Stephen Thong. Oh, a pretty looking play, but the shot not there. Very fortunate where the Eagles that time did not give up that basket. And then here's one from Jamar King. And he may have led Terrell Jones just a little too much on that pass as Terrell was headed to the basket. And the ball ends up out of bounds. So here comes Wickett out of the basketball game. Dwight Wilson will come into the basketball game. Ray Jackson will also sit down. And looks like number 13, Anthony Sullen, back onto the floor for head coach Miguel Johnson and Contra Costa College. Stephen Thong out to Sullen. Sullen wants to go baseline. There's the double team. He's got to kick it out, but the ball is intercepted by Noel Crabtree. Here's Jamar King. Blatchnick, the long left wing three, and he knocks it down. David Blatchnick. He's missed a couple here tonight, but he's also made a couple from way, way downtown. Sullen working against Blatchnick, puts it up and knocks it down, way downtown. So Sullen, several steps beyond the arc, he knocks it down at 66. To 56, and now we have a whistle here at the timeline. And they're gonna call this against the Comets with the hole. So the Comets into the bonus. One more and they'll be into the double bonus. So this will be a 1-and-1 situation for Tyrell Jones. A 10-point lead, 66-56. 6:24 here to go in the second half. And Jones makes the first, so he'll get the second. Three, Tyrell, and this one just does rim out. The lead is 9. Mark that down at the 6:20 mark. Sullen to his left, right into Jamar King. Put up and home, as ending up with the ball was DeAndre Russell, who puts in the basket. All really created by that drive. Jones looking into Jamar King. Do they get it to Jamar? They do. Jamar back to the basket, puts it up, can't get the shot to go. They wrestle with it. We're going to have a jump ball. I'm looking for the possession arrow. We have not had a possession arrow situation here tonight. But we're going to get our first one, and the rock belongs to the Comets. So the next such situation, the ball will go over to the Eagles. That was the first time they tried Jamar King in the post in the second half. Came up just a bit short with it that time. Here's Anthony Sullen driving in. Leaves it in the corner. Wilson has it. Looking for someone to pass to. There's the shot put up, and that's off the rim. No good. Tipped around. Wilson comes out of the pack with it. Now Wilson will be willing to take some time off the clock here. Here Sullen goes in, and now we have the bodies collide. The basket went in. I think they waved off the basket. There's an Eagle on the floor. I believe it's David Mlachnik. It is. He's back up and it's okay. And now we're going to have a foul call. A blocking is going to be the call against the Eagles, and Anthony Sullen is going to go to the free throw line. They did not, however, count the basket. So it's going to be 2 shots upcoming for Anthony Sullen. And now they're going to change it. Sullen was standing at the free throw line, and now they're going to say he was not, and that was very strange. I thought he was clearly in the act of shooting. Instead, it's an inbound situation here for the Comets. See if they want to run some more time. They don't. Sullen comes in, can't get it to go. Jamar King cleans up the rebound for the Eagles. Eagles down 11. Mlachnik along 3. That won't go. He's hit 2 of those, but he's missed about 5. Here's Sullen. Short jumper as he pulls up. That one rattles home. Very nicely done by the Comets in that transition offense, going from defense to offense quickly and getting the short jump shot, the high percentage too. Here's a low percentage shot, Mlachnik, that won't go. And here come the Comets running again. 3-on-2, all the way, blocked away by Tyrell Jones. Get out, says Jones, off the shot of Denzel Walker, number 15. But the ball is out of bounds to the Comets. 70-57 is our score, a 13-point Comet lead. Time is a waste in here for the Eagles, just 4:28 to go in the game. Let's see whether or not at some point do the Comets try to take some time off the clock. That jump shot won't go. Bobby Siebenthal gets the rebound. They reset the shot clock, and Siebenthal will be content to run some time off this clock. Smart play by the Comets after getting the offensive rebound. Siebenthal, the pull-up 3, that won't go. And this time it comes back to Paul Stoliga. Stoliga, Jamar King from the elbow. King lets that one go. That one won't fall. It's going to be out of bounds and stays with the Eagles. So still a whole lot of time here, a 13-point lead, and certainly the Eagles can run this off fairly quickly. And the Comets call timeout here. The Eagles over to talk at their bench. Likewise for Contra Costa. I'll take my coffee break right now, and we'll be back with some more play-by-play here from the Comets and the Eagles in this Bay Valley Conference matchup. Be back in just a moment. Thank you. right players back on the floor. Here's the situation. Just one tick under 4 minutes to go. And it's a 13-point Comets lead, as you can see there, 70-57. Contra Costa over Modesto. Or, pardon me, Modesto, Mendocino. Got my M's mixed up there. Here's Crabtree. Out to Jones. Jones watched by Larry Wickett. Going back. He puts it up, gets a shot blocked, but he draws the foul. It's been a good-looking matchup of really good athletes there between Wickett and Tyrell Jones. Jones wins that battle. So the Eagles like what they see there. The clock stops, and they get a chance to shoot free throws. But they have not been lights out with their free throws so far tonight. Tyrell gets that one to go, and he cuts the lead to 12. Deontay Smith, number 21, is checked back into the game for Coach Miguel Johnson. Second shot, and that is no good. Wickett chases down the rebound, and here comes Larry into the front court. Long three-point shot from the corner. That is knocked down by Ray Jackson. 73-58. Eagles falling further behind. Here's a spin into a double team out to Crabtree. Tyrell Jones, everybody being covered up quickly. Paul. Stoliga going in. Stoliga draws the foul, and he'll go to the foul line for two. So the Eagles like that when they can stop the clock and get to the free throw line. The problem is, back on the other side of the floor, the Comets continue to make baskets. And that last one was a three-point shot by Ray Jackson, number 11. Stoliga hits the first of his two foul shots, 73-59. Second one, he knocks it down, 73-60. So the lead back to 13 after a high of 15. 3:23 and counting. Ray Jackson backs up, takes that jumper, and gets it to go. Hits one side of the rim, then the other, and then falls straight through. Lead back to 15, and now we have a whistle away from the ball, pointing at Jamar King. I think it's going to be somebody working against Jamar King. It is. It's going to be Deontay Smith, number 21, called for that foul. So Deontay called for the foul, and Jamar King will go to the free throw line. Big shot by Jamar off the back iron, no good. And the Eagles have certainly done themselves no favors by missing quite a few foul shots here tonight. 75-61. Siebenthong into the front court as we take under 3 minutes. Turnaround jump shot by Larry Wickett. That won't go. But the offensive rebound is collected and put down by Deontay Smith, crashing the boards, getting the rebound and the bucket. Well, the Eagles can ill afford to trade baskets here. Here's Jamar King trying to go into the post, using that big body to back up the defender. Lost the ball, and then I believe committed the foul. So they tried to go inside to Jamar. That didn't work. And right now, the Comets are in good shape here, up 77-61, 2:41 to go here in the ball game. The ladies' game will follow. Contra Costa College against Laney, as the women have the nightcap. And now we have a timeout on the floor. Timeout call here with 2:41 to go. It's a 16-point lead for the Comets. I'll take a quick break. You are watching Bay Valley, the Bay Valley Conference, right here on Bay Area Sports TV. I'm Anthony Schultz. Everything here sponsored by ASU, the Contra Costa College Associated Student Union. Thank you. right, here's Bobby Siebenthong at the line for the Comets, trying to add to a 16-point lead, and can't do so. Jones the rebound. Eagles got to hurry, and now here's a foul by Wicket here in the backcourt, trying to stay off of Tyrell Jones, but couldn't do so. Foul shots for Terrell, and he knocks down the first, so he'll get the second. And Jones gets them both. 14-point lead, 2.5 to go. Siebenthong off to Larry Wicket, and the shot taken. That was might have been partially blocked that time as it's loose. Here comes the Eagles the other way. There's Crabtree wants a three, can't get it. Deontay Smith skying for the rebound as he took it away from Muhammad Holloway. Nice play by Deontay. And let's see if the Comets will be content to take some more time off the clock. Wicket, and he gets it out to Siebenthong. Smart play there. Let that clock run a little bit. Siebenthong, nice no-look pass inside to Anthony Sullen, who lays it in. Bobby Siebenthong with the no-look. Beautifully done. Three-point shot. That is good. Tyrell Jones answers quickly, but it really is the Comets pulling away here. Clock continues to run, 1:40 and counting, and the lead is 13. Here's Wicket. Ray Jackson, alley-oop try again, and that was no good as that pass was wide left. Ray Jackson looking for Anthony Sullen, and that one was just not close enough to the basket. So they pulled that off a couple of times tonight where it's looked beautiful. A couple of other times, not so pretty. And here's Stoliga driving in, and he draws the foul. So the Eagles have really been able to extend this game by getting to the foul line, but unfortunately for them, they have not been able to stop the Comets going the other way. Goes to Liga to shoot a couple of foul shots. Still trailing by 13. First one no good, and now one more for Paul. Next one is good. Racing all the way, and that pass is going to almost get away. Now they're going to throw it into the backcourt. Siebenthong will gather up, and that'll be the backcourt violation there. So the Eagles will take over. 79-68, still a minute 12 to go in this ball game. It's an 11-point lead, seemingly comfortable for the Comets. There's a couple of times when they've been in the offensive set, they've been willing to take some time off the clock, but that has really not been what they've done most of the time. Nice inbound pass, but the shot missed by Tyrell Jones. Offensive rebound by Stoliga, but then he throws the ball away trying to get it back to Tyrell. That was an opportunity missed right there. Here's some full court defense. Siebenthong with it's got a couple of guys on him. Gets away from one, gets away from two, gets the ball to Wilson. Wilson down into the corner. Shot put up, that won't go. They battle for it. It's going to be out of bounds off of Deontay Smith. Under a minute to go now. You see some of the ladies here tonight. They're heading off to the locker room to get ready. Timeout is the call. 55.2 seconds to go here in the ball game. An 11-point Comet lead. And the Comets trying to salt this one away. And you got to figure in that huddle with Miguel Johnson, he probably say, hey, guys, when we get the ball to the offensive side, let's go ahead and let's take some time here. Why give the Eagles, who have been drawing plenty of fouls and getting to the foul line, why give them more opportunities to get back into this ball game? I mean, if you're the Eagles, you want to see as many possessions left in this ball game as possible. If you're the Comets, you want just the opposite. All right, gentlemen, back on the floor. Eagles to inbound. Comets showing some full court pressure here. They pick up at half court, nearly a steal. Blachnik's got it. He goes to the rack, gets it off to Crabtree. Crabtree in the corner. Here's Tyrell Jones against Siventhong. He puts it up. Oh, that ball was online, but couldn't get it to go. Offensive rebound. Blachnik, he can't get it to go. Jones going for the rebound, and he's going to commit the foul. So the Eagles working really hard that time, but down to a half minute to go here. Nearly a steal, ball's loose. Eagles come up with it, Stoliga the shot, and he knocks down the three. 79-71, the scoreboard hasn't changed. Down to 22.6 to go. Body hit the floor here on the other, as the Comets were going the other way. So the whistle stops play here momentarily. There they've got the score right now on the scoreboard. 79-71. So the lead is still 8. Still a 3-possession game. And the Comets going to go to the line here with number 11, Ray Jackson. Well, this will be a 2-shot situation for Ray. And the Eagles got to hope he misses them both. First shot. No, that was actually not a 2-shot situation, a 1-and-1. He missed the first. They figure the Eagles have got to think about fouling more now. The shot won't go up, won't go in. Jackson the rebound, trying to keep possession. Tick down to 4 seconds, 7 seconds, pardon me. He's going to go all the way, and Jackson lays it in for the score, and that could very well be the final basket of the game. There's one last heave, that won't go, and a final score. Here from San Pablo, the home team, the Contra Costa Comets, win it by 10 over the Mendocino Eagles. A final score, 81-71, as the Comets run their league record now in the Bay Valley Conference to 6-7-1, and their overall record to 18-6. And for Mendocino, they drop to 3-5 in the BVC, and their overall record now drops to 9-14. Well, that does it here for the men's half of our doubleheader. Stay tuned. We'll have the ladies coming in. They'll start in just a little while. We'll step aside and be back with the tip-off of the women's game in just a few moments.